regards the world ruled by the king Indradyumna as a tranquil place. From his capital in Avantipura, he surveyed a land filled with prosperity and peace, unknown in modern times. Abundance was everywhere, except in the heart of King Indradyumna, because he longed to see the face of the Lord face to face.
One day, as Indradyumna lamented that he was not able to serve the Lord directly, a pilgrim suddenly appeared. This man revealed how he had actually seen the Lord accept direct loving service in his deity form, Nila Madhav. God incarnates in many ways throughout the ages, and sometimes he manifests in the form of stone or wood just to please his devotees and accept their loving service. The traveler described how on the remote mountain top of Niladri, he had seen the demigods worshipping the Lord. With this, I would like to chant a sloka from Bhagavad Gita, chapter 11, verse 6. Pasya dityan vasunrudran ashvino marutastatha bahunya adrishta purvani pasya charyani bharata. This means, O best of Bharatas, see here the different manifestations of Adityas, Vasus, Rudras, Ashwini Kumaras, and all other demigods. Behold the many wonderful things which no one has ever seen or heard of before.
The Brahmana further describes in a sacred place a beautiful form of Supreme Personality of Godhead Vasudeva is worshipped. The deity resides on top of a blue mountain named Neelachal, which is surrounded by dense forest. One who takes darshan of the deity gets liberation.
Hearing this, the king was elated and summoned all his best men. Among them, he selected a Brahmin named Vidyapati. Vidyapati was so much excited and delighted. He was so much lost in the devotion and thought of Lord Vishnu that he never felt hunger or thirst throughout his journey.
After a month's journey without rest, Vidyapati found Mount Niladri, where he found Shabaras, low-born pig herders. The chieftain Vishwavasu had been worshipping the Lord in great secrecy. Every time he returned after worshipping Lord Nilamadhava, his body emitted a divine fragrance, and this surprised Vidyapati.
Vidyapati was offered varieties of prasadam. He was surprised to see such opulent prasadam and wanted to know from where did Vishwavasu get all those. Then Vishwavasu explained that this prasadam was offered by an demigods headed by Indra to Lord Nilamadhava, who visited Neelachal mountain every day.
Looking beyond class distinctions, Vidyapati married the daughter of the tribal chieftain. Due to his daughter's pleas, Vishwavasu finally agreed to show Neelachala the residing place of Nilamadhava, only if he went there blindfolded.
But the Brahmin tricked his father-in-law by sprinkling the mustard seeds along the path, seeds that would eventually sprout and lead the emperor back to claim the Lord's attention. The Sabara led Vidyapati through the dense forest to the base of the sacred blue mountains. As they climbed higher and higher, the path became narrow, so they had to walk in a single file. Vidyapati went in the path following the voice of Vishwavasu.
After a long night of walking, they reached Rohini Kund in the morning. O great Brahmana, this is Rohini Kund, the cause of all water in the universe. This is the best of all Tirthas. By taking bath here, one automatically becomes eligible to go to Vaikuntha. In between the tree and pond, there is a great grove where the Lord, who is revealed through Vedant, is residing.
Vidyapati trembled in anticipation. After carefully taking bath in Rohini Kunda, he remembered his guru and entered the temple to take darshana of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, offering the Hare Krishna Mahamantra. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. He had never experienced such a bliss in his life. After returning to Vishwasu's house, Vidyapati expressed the desire of King Indrayumna to build a beautiful temple for Lord Vishnu. After a few days of stay, he left for Avantipura. All through the way, he meditated on Lord Nilamadava. Jai Jagannath Swami, Jai Jagannath, Jai Jagannath Swami, Jai Jagannath, Jai Jagannath Swami, Jai Jagannath, Jaya Baladeva, Jaya Subhadra.
When Vidyapati returned, he presented King Indridyumna Prasada, fresh garland of Sri Nila Madhav. Receiving this, the king was ecstatic and prayed to the Lord. Everyone surrounded there were relishing the sight of king's pure love for Lord Vishnu. Now I would like to chant a sloka from Bhagavad Gita, chapter 3, verse 13.
Yajna shishta shinashanto munchate sarva kilbishai bunjate tva agam papa epachanti atmakaranat.
This means, the devotees of the Lord are released from all kinds of sin because they eat food which is offered first for sacrifice. Others who prepare food for personal sense enjoyment rarely eat only sin.
Vidyapati relates to King Indradyumna about the glories of Nila Madhava and Neelachal mountain. Vidyapati gives a garland to King Indradyumna. King Indradyumna wears it. He feels the waves of love coming in his heart and he feels the power of the universe and lots of bhakti.
The king finally asked Vidyapati to describe about Indranila Mani Maya. The deity of the Lord is very ancient and his form is made up of many precious gems. Lord Brahma and King Indra along with the demigods visit daily to worship the deity. The garland I presented to you was offered by the demigods to Madhava. It will never dry and its fragrance remains always never fading with time. Captured by Vidyapati's rich glorification, the whole assembly drank the nectar of the Brahmana's words and wished he could speak more and more.
Vidyapati says, "Dear King, sense gratification and liberation are easily available in Neelachala Dhama. There is no disease or old age, nor any kind of suffering. The Supreme Lord Himself, with His big blue lotus-like eyes, resides here. He is very pleased by our devotional service and awards liberation to anyone who takes shelter of Him. The temple of Lord Nilamadava in Neelachala Dhama in the evening is so cool and soothing. The gently smiling lotus face of the deity removes all the miseries of the material world. The nose of the Lord is like a sesame flower. The long ears are motar tundala. His shoulders are strong and wide. His four long arms end at his knees."
Hearing the narration by Vidyapati, the king said, "I have been purified by hearing the glories of Lord and His Dham. I will go there and establish a city of opulence." Just then, Narada Muni arrived at the place. The king welcomed the saintly guest. Now I would like to chant a sloka from Bhagavad Gita, chapter 10, verse 9.
मच्चितमद्गतप्राणाबोधयन्तपरस्परं कथयन्तश्च मां नित्यं तुष्यन्ति चरमन्ति च
This means, with their minds fixed on me and their lives surrendered to me, my devotees remain ever contented in me. They derive the great satisfaction and bliss in enlightening one another about me and conversing about my glories.
The king of Utkala says that the Lord's dham is covered by a thick layer of sand due to sudden heavy storm. Hearing this, the king was worried that his heart's desire would not be fulfilled. Narad Muni consoles the king. The next day, the king took bath in the Brindu Sarovara. The king worshipped Lord Bhuvaneshwar, and soon the king's desire was fulfilled by Lord Shiva. Lord Shiva to Narad Muni. O great sage, fulfill Brahmaji's desire by the king.
For their surprise, when they went further, they saw a deity of Lord Narasimhadev under a black agar tree. The Lord destroys all danger and fear. So, a sacred command was carefully carried by the king. Narada Muni installs the deity of Lord Narasimha.
When they reached the holy place, the deity was covered by golden sand. Narad Muni consoled the king that now the Lord will manifest in four forms to bless you.
As per the instructions from Narada Muni, the king built a huge temple to welcome the four forms of the Lord. The Lord himself will appear as Daru Brahma to deliver the helpless conditioned souls. Lord Shiva and Durga Devi are appointed in 8 different places as the protectors of that place.
The king worships Sachipati Indra and offers obeisances to the Vaishnavas. Indra replied, with the help of great rishis, the yajna was performed without any mistake. The Ashwamedha Yajna that Indra refers to is a horse sacrifice ritual that was practiced by the ancient kings. It was a Shrota tradition of the Vedic religion and communities. A white horse accompanied by the king's warriors and soldiers would be left to wander around the kingdom for a period of 1 year.
During the 1000th Ashwamedha Yajna, King Indradyumna, in his meditation upon Lord Vishnu, saw the Shvetadvipa. When the king discloses the details to Narada Muni, the hair from the body of Vishnu has fallen to the earth and developed into a Brahmarupa tree. They visit the tree, offer obeisances, and it has to be carved into a deity form. An old carpenter with instruments comes to carve the deities. He is Lord Vishnu's secret messenger. After 15 days, with various kirtanas and musical instruments, the carving was carried out. King Indradyumna, because of curiosity, opened the door.
He sees Jagannatha, Baladeva and Subhadra.
An unseen voice directed to the king, O king, cover these deities in cloth, paint and natural colors. Remember to paint them every year. The merciful Lord has appeared to bestow his blessings upon you and all living entities. So you must build a temple 1,000 feet in height. Thus, Sri Mandir stands as a crest of all temples.
Jai Jai Jagannath Sachiranandan Tripuvane Kureja Charanavandan. Jai Jai Jagannath Sachiranandan Tripuvane Kureja Charanavandan.
Hari Bol to Jagannatha Swami.
Hari Bol.